I'm delighted to be here with Ken Everett. Hello, Ken.
Hi, Robert.
Now, Ken, in business, clearly there are a number of kind of scenarios, situations where, to use some of your language, we do have to think on our feet.
Mm-hmm.
We have to kind of make a decision and go with it. What are some tips? How can we do this? This is an area that you specialize in.
I'd be happy to give a couple of tips. Let me just clarify, perhaps first, what we mean by thinking on your feet. That might be useful. We mean being able to get your ideas across in the moment, on the spot, and to do so clearly, concisely, and memorably.
Okay, it's a skill, right. Isn't it?
And well, and it's not been very much addressed. You see, people go to presentation skills workshops so they can deliver their ideas formally, but the informal side, which is 90% of the time that people are getting their ideas across, hasn't really been addressed, and that's the niche that we uniquely go after.
Come on, how do we do it?
Okay, three tips. Number one, think structures. Organize ideas in terms of common structures. I'll give you one in a moment. Number two, use the rule of threes. Now, stick to two, three, or four points, but three is a good rule of thumb. For example, if I were to ask you about your business, and I said, tell me about it, you said, well, there's really one thing I can tell you about my business. We might think it's a bit thin.
Right.
If on the other hand, you said, well, let me tell you the 17 things that are neat about my business.
That might be a bit fast.
Exactly.
Right.
So, on balance, somewhere in the middle, and about three is about the right number. Now, by the way, I've just used one of our structures there. On the one hand, on the other hand, on balance. And it's a simple structure that which enables me to capture that idea. I mean, Hegel, the great philosopher, called it thesis, antithesis, and synthesis, and, you know, the dialectic. But what was it? In the Three Bears?
Yeah.
The porridge was too hot, too cold, and just right. I mean,
you're using your hands here a lot as well.
Well,
so again, in that situation, this presumably is useful because it lets people know kind of where you're going and what you're doing.
Well, not only that, when I say on the one hand, what are you already thinking of?
The next one.
On the other hand.
Yes.
If I say before, during, what are you waiting for? After.
Yep.
If I say morning, afternoon, you're waiting for? Evening. See, if I can contain my ideas in simple structures and patterns that work for people, then that's the way the brain
Fantastic.
Works. The way
so
they like
structures
it.
Was your
structures,
first point.
Three-part structures.
Three parts.
And this enables you to use both sides of the brains, and this is how it works. If you can lock a simple structure into the left-hand side of your brain, which is good for logic, it frees you up to be creative in the right side of the brain around those ideas. So, for example, let's say we're to use a simple time structure to talk about your business. We could talk about its origins, where you are today, and your vision for the future. So I was to ask you about the origins of your business. Could you give me two sentences about that?
I could.
Well, why not? Can you do it now, right now, for me?
I could, but I'm not going to.
You're not going to, okay. But if the listener can imagine that they did this for their own business, right, and then they spoke for two or three sentences about where they are today and their vision for the future, then they've got the simple structure in the left brain has enabled them to extemporize with the right brain. So, think structures, think three-part structures, and then think about using both sides of the brain and using the structure as the trigger point, as the platform, as the database access key to get at all that stuff we know that we didn't know that we knew.
Fantastic. And because it's so often you meet people and you ask them a question and then 10 minutes later you think, God, I wish I hadn't asked that
exactly.
question. So this gives us some, as you say, a structure and a way that we can do this.
Sure. And it saves that feeling, as you say, of walking out of the room and saying, that's what
I
should
have.
Exactly.
Thank you so much for joining us, Ken. So if you want to find out more of these kind of tips, I know we can go to your website, which is www.thinkonyourfeet.com.
Exactly.
Thank you very much for joining
us. You're very welcome, Robert.